praise and thank God for this wonderful opportunity God has given us to worship and praise Him together. Can we all rise up? Can we all stand up in our places? Amen. Today, all over the world, people are celebrating love. Amen. And we are in the presence of God just because God loves us more than anything in this world. Amen. God loves us with a love which is unconditional, which is everlasting and unchanging. Amen. Hallelujah. This morning, how many of you are happy to be in the presence of God, worshiping and praising God? That's what the song says. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. We are here to lift up his holy name and give praises to God Almighty. Amen. Can we sing this song together and give praises to God Almighty? Amen. Of the glory and the honor, Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor, Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. For you are great, you're a miracle so great, there is no one else like you, and there is no one else like you. For you are great, you're a miracle so great, there is no one else like you, and there is no one else like you. For you are great, for you are great, you're a miracle so great, there is no one else like you, and there is no one else like you. For you are great, you're a miracle so great, there is no one else like you, and there is no one else like you. Stuthichu paadidum മഹിമയങ്ങേക്കു ഞാനൻ കരങ്ങളെ ഉയർത്തി അങ്ങേക്കെന്നും ആരാധന സ്തുതിച്ച് പാടിടും മഹിമയങ്ങേക്കു ഞാനൻ കരങ്ങളെ ഉയർത്തി അങ്ങേക്കെന്നും ആരാധന യേശു വലിയവൻ അത്ഭുതങ്ങൾ ചെയ്യുന്നവൻ അങ്ങേ പോലെ ആരുമില്ല അങ്ങേ പോലെ ആരുമില്ല യേശു വലിയവൻ അത്ഭുതങ്ങൾ ചെയ്യുന്നവൻ അങ്ങേ പോലെ ആരുമില്ല അങ്ങേ പോലെ ആരുമില്ല അങ്ങേ പോലെ ആരുമില്ല no one else like you, and there is no one else like you. For you are great, you're a miracle so great, there is no one else like you, and there is no one else like you, and there is no
give you all the glory. We praise you, God. Hallelujah. We praise you, Master. Hallelujah. Anoint us, Almighty God. We give you all the glory, Almighty God. You are worthy to be praised, Almighty God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise you, Master. We adore you, Almighty God. We give you glory, Almighty God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise you, Master. Hallelujah. Anoint us, Almighty God. Hallelujah. Fill us with your Holy Spirit, Almighty God. Hallelujah.
My strength, my shield, to you.
desire and I long to worship.
Can we lift up our hands and sing this song together?
Oh, you alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship you. May my spirit hear. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long
just together sing.
To worship you.
Oh,
you alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit hear. Desire, and I long to worship you.
We worship you. We worship you, Lord. We adore you, Master. We sing praises unto your name, Lord Father. We glorify your name, Master. We praise you, Lord. We adore you for who you are. Thank you, Lord, for loving us. Thank you for your unconditional love, Lord. Thank you for your everlasting love, our Father. Thank you for your unchanging love, Master. Thank you for holding us together, Lord Father. Thank you for carrying us each and every day, Lord Father. It's just your grace and mercy that we live, that we sustain, that we survive, Lord Father, Master. Thank you, Lord. We give it all into your hands, O Lord Father, Lord. Thank you, Master. Thank you for being our Father. Thank you for being our loving Father, Abba. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Basai Baba Bala Jana. Basai Baba Baba. We worship you, Lord. Now Sri Kuti will pray and conclude our English worship.
Everlasting Father, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, we ask that as we start this service, may your abiding presence go with us. We cannot do anything except your presence comes, Lord. Come, O Lord, with your power, with your grace, fill this place with your glory, Lord. Lord, we commit all the activities today in your hands. Let everything we do to be glory, and at the end, let us be refreshed with your presence. Thank you for great grace you have granted us to be effective in this ministry. Thank you for glory that's revealed in us today. In the precious name of Jesus, amen.
Please be seated. Once again, I welcome you all to this place. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you to this place. And God is going to speak to you through His word. Hallelujah. Be patient to get something extraordinary from God, uncommon and surprising from God. Somebody say, hallelujah. Somebody say, amen. Amen. My message will be brief. And I want you to be faithful to God, carefully listening the word of God, and you will never be the same. Not because of me, because of the word of God that can transform you and change you, that can do miracles in our life. We're going to hear the word of God. The word of God is powerful. Somebody say, amen. Hallelujah. You will never be the same. You will leave this place with peace in your heart. You will leave this place with your sins forgiven. Hallelujah. Let God do miracles in our midst. Hallelujah. This morning I would like to speak to you from Luke chapter 10. Beginning at the 25th word. You may open up your Bible and Turn with me to Luke chapter 10, beginning at the 25th word. One of you can read.
On one occasion, an expert in the law stood up to Jesus. Teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? What is this written in the law? He replied, how do you read it? He answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. But he wanted to justify himself, so he asked Jesus, and who is my neighbor? In reply, Jesus said, a man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was, and when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring in oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day he took out of 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. Look after him, he said, and when I return, I will reimburse you for any extra expense you may have.
Yes, that's enough. Hallelujah. We are all familiar with this parable of Good Samaritan. One law expert came to Jesus and asked, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? Jesus was asked this question about 19 times, that is recorded in the gospel in various forms. Before we go further, let me ask you, why people ask this question to Jesus? I would say, the people recognized Jesus as eternal God, not a man-made God. Eternal God is eternal. Jesus is eternal, everlasting, long-lasting God. That's the reason why the people asked, "How? What shall to do? What shall we do to inherit eternal life?" Let me ask you a question. Have you recognized Jesus Christ as eternal God? That is the greatest revelation that you and me must need. We must recognize Jesus as eternal God. Not a silly God. Not a man-made God. Not a myth. But he is eternal. He is everlasting. He is long-lasting. No one like him. Come on, put your hands together and praise God. Hallelujah. Here we can see many people over here in this parable. Exactly, it is not a parable. It is not a story. It is an actual event. But we people believe that it is a parable. And we can see many people over here. One wounded man. Again, one Samaritan, again one priest, one Levite, a certain thieves, innkeeper. Many people are mentioned in these parables. Let me ask you, who do the thieves represent here? Who does the wounded man represent? Who does the Good Samaritan represent? Who does the priest represent? Who does the Levite represent? Let me tell you, the devil represents the thieves. Again, mankind and humanity represents the wounded man. Jesus Christ represents the Good Samaritan. The priest represent tradition, useless tradition. And again, the Levite represent the useless religion. It is not mentioned Samaritan as good Samaritan, but we call him good Samaritan. Why? Many reasons for that. Let me tell you some reasons. First one is that the good Samaritan was willing to get involved in that matter. Again, the good Samaritan was generous. He was willing to spare his oil. He was willing to spare his wine. He was willing to spare his money. Again, he was willing to spare his time. Again, the good Samaritan was ready to serve. For service, he was ready. And again, he was equipped with the items to serve the people. The wine, the oil, the money. He was equipped. He was ready to postpone his activities in order to save one person. Hallelujah. That is the qualities of the good Samaritan that makes the Samaritan good. He was willing to travel anywhere for the salvation of the people. Hallelujah. That is important. That is the peculiarities of the good Samaritan. Again, here we read that an expert in law came to Jesus and asked, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? Yes, he was expert in Old Testament, but he was not expert in New Testament. That is the reason why he couldn't understand who Jesus was, who Jesus is. He was expert in the Old Testament, but was not expert in New Testament. He was not firm concerning eternal things, heavenly things. Hallelujah. We must be confirmed. We must be sure about the upcoming future hope, upcoming heaven. We must be aware of eternal life that Jesus can give you. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. Here Jesus says that do this and you will live. Let me, it is 20 words, 20, 28. You answered correctly. Jesus replied, do this and you will live. What is mean by this word? Jesus says that if you do the will of God, if you do something for the expansion of the kingdom of God, you will live. If you don't do something for the expansion of God, the kingdom of God, you will die. That is the greatest revelation you and we must understand. In order to get rid of death, you must involved in gospel work. You must be involved in gospel work. You must spend your time to save people from the bondage of sin, from the dominion of darkness. Somebody say hallelujah. Again, let me give you another thought. Why robbers couldn't kill him? They left him half dead. This we read that they left him half dead. Yes, they stripped him of his clothes, beat him and went away, leaving him half dead. They could not kill him. Why? I would say God has an assigned plan concerning that wounded man. That is the reason why they couldn't kill him. You are sustaining. You are alive. Why? God has an assigned plan concerning you. Somebody say hallelujah. Yes, that's going to be unfold in the coming days. Come on, put your hands together and praise God. Hallelujah. God has an assigned plan concerning your future. God has an assigned plan concerning your family. God has an assigned plan concerning your church. God has an assigned plan concerning your ministry. Somebody say hallelujah. Yes. Again, one more thought. Why the priest and Levi didn't help the wounded man? The answer is that they were not equipped enough to save the wounded man. They lack oil. They lack wine. They lack money. That's the reason why they couldn't help the wounded man. Jesus said, go and do likewise. Yes. Which of these three do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of the robbers? The expert in law looked pride, the one who had mercy on him. Jesus told him, go and do likewise. What we must do? Yes. Go to the place where a wounded man lying. Have compassion on the people who are wounded by devil. Bandage their wounds, pouring oil and wine. Spare your time and vehicle to serve the people. Bring the wounded man to the inner and to the innkeeper. Yes, use your money to save the people. Give promise to the people who take care of wounded people that you will reimburse.